Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to a roundtable here at American Airgunner. I'm joined by the godfather of air guns, Jim Chapman and Rick Eutsler. Guys, today we are talking buying used air guns. I know there's a lot of that, and even like hand-me-downs. Now, I personally have a strict rule. Never buy an air gun. You should just get them from the sponsors of your show. But if that doesn't work for everyone else,
that's my rule.
Steal them out of a drawer.
Steal them from you guys. What's the best way to, or the biggest thing to look for when you're buying a used air gun? Let's start with you.
What I do is stay with brands I know. And you may think I know all about air guns, but I don't. I do. There's a lot of brands out there I'm not familiar with, Rossi, and I just don't buy them used. If I'm allowed to shoot them, which is the best of all things, then I cock them, I shoot them, I listen to them, and I can get a pretty good idea of what's going on. And the last thing I do is I buy it right. So if the doggone thing needs to be completely rebuilt, at least I've got a good shell there, I can afford to rebuild it.
If you buy a used air gun and you do want to get it worked on, what's the best place to get it worked on?
Well, it depends on the gun, obviously,
sure.
As always. Some manufacturers actually have service departments that you can send it back in or have it worked on. A lot of different garage businesses or small businesses that will take an air gun and tune it up. Usually if you buy a used gun, you may want to have it tuned anyway. The one thing I was going to say, Tom, is that it always helps to know who you're buying it from.
Oh yeah.
So if the person has a good sort of like on eBay, they have the good reputation.
Sure.
There are people that have good reputations, and there are people that you want to avoid.
Mm-hmm.
And if you get on the forums and some of the people that are selling the guns, you can tell very quickly if they've not been terribly truthful in the past, and people will avoid them.
Yeah, when I buy air guns, mostly the used guns I bought have been PCPs. And I'm usually buying them online. So I go to one of the forums you mentioned. One of the forums, the Yellow Forum, has a board of inquiry, for instance, where the seller, his track record is published. So if he sold 10 guns, you can look to see what the experience was. But if I'm at a gun show and I'm looking at guns, I spend a lot of time looking at just the general condition of the gun. It might not be correct, but I think if the outside looks bad, the inside probably doesn't look a lot better.
And listen to the seller when you're at the gun show. If the guy says, this thing shoots real powerful, I cock it and shoot it all the time. Well, you got some pellets? Oh no, I don't have any pellets for it. He's been dry firing it. And they do that a lot. And that's not good for spring guns.
Specific, let's talk springers. Because I know this is where you're, what are common things you would see in an old gun or a misused gun?
One thing I really look for is see if the barrel's bent upwards.
Barrel drooping.
Well, I look the barrel bent upwards because these Magnum springers, they'll cock it and it'll slip out of their hand. And the barrel will fly up, and the barrel will go like that.
They say they slip out of their hand. You know that they are trying to see how quick the barrel will close when they pull the trigger.
Rick, what are we looking at here?
This is some stuff that's inside the gun, and this goes back to what Tom was saying about being able to shoot it. You're not going to know if you're going to have this kind of damage.
What am I looking at here?
That is a seal on an internal piston, and that seal has been abused pretty thoroughly.
The other thing I've noticed, I don't know if you guys have seen it, but when I'm looking at a springer and I'm at a place where I can shoot it, I cock it. Sometimes you get a gun that has a really rough cocking,
yeah,
and it's gritty,
yeah.
You know, something's just not right
something's
in it.
Wrong.
And I've opened those up and there have been springs that have been broken into to multiple pieces. And you'll get that from kind of the smoothness of the mechanics, how everything's fitting and working together.
In the brand, you mentioned brand, go back to that for a minute. There are some name brands that are good, like RWS is good, Y-Rock,
Valzer.
Yeah, and some of these that even if there are a little issues with them, the parts are available, you can rebuild them, and they're gonna be probably worth the investment.
I would think the guns that probably get dealt the most and sold are PCPs. Those are expensive guns, so if I'm a first-time buyer, I might wanna buy a used one. What do I need to look for there if I'm looking for a PCP?
Yeah, well, I mean, one of the things I looked is to see that it's holding air.
Yeah.
Because that's the big thing is they can leak. And a lot of times people get frustrated with them because they have a slow leak. And often it's just something simple like an O-ring replacement. But I look, and if I'm looking at a gun in a gun show and it's empty, to me that sends up a warning sign
Absolutely.
Right there, because they didn't empty it to come to the show. There should be some pressure.
Right.
So you want to make sure that it holds there. And then I do the same thing. I just look at the general condition.
Should you ever buy a used gun if you can't shoot it?
I do it when I'm buying online all the time, actually.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah, and again, that's why it's good to know the credibility of the person you're buying from.
As long as we're talking about buying online, look for things like blurry pictures, dark pictures, and pictures of the gun way off in the distance. That's a guy who's trying to hide something.
Okay.
And it happens all the time.
Look at you. You're so internet savvy. Oh, yeah.
Then they say it happened in shipping. I don't know what happened. Yeah. When I shipped the gun, it was perfect. And you get it, and it's bent into a pretzel.
Yeah. And rusted.
Last question. Do you guys have a go-to place for used air guns?
I like air gun shows, but I also shop Gun Broker, which is a gun retail auction site.
Okay. Yeah.
I use the Yellow Forum and their Board of Inquiry. It's one of the big American air gun forums.
We've all been on there. people send you guns.
You're not
wasting time with used guns.
What I like to do is actually help people sell their used guns. So I'm working on a way to do that.
There you go. So Airgun Web. All right, well, guys, there you go. So just be smart when you're buying used air guns. And, of course, try to buy from someone that you know, respect. And most importantly, do not take the air gun apart when you get it. Which is exactly what I would do. All right, that's it for this roundtable. Check everything out, please, on AmericanAirGunner.com. We'll be right back with more American Airgunner right after this.
When we return, Rick Eutsler will be with us talking about the highly anticipated Umarex Fuel air rifle.